folks, and welcome back to my channel. We're playing Red Dead. As we know, yesterday, John arrived home. And everything's gonna be fine, I'm sure of it. Nothing bad's gonna happen. It's all good. He's home with family. See, here's Abigail. She's cooking. Yeah, howdy. Got Uncle, got Jack, got Abigail. Everything's fine. Everything's peachy. Nothing bad's gonna happen, obviously.
What you cooking?
Same thing I've been cooking the past 15 years with the hope of poisoning you.
Ain't working so well.
Not yet.
To be honest, though, it tastes bad enough to kill a man.
I never was much of a cook, but I did try to be a good wife.
And you have been.
Given what we was and what we came from, I think we've gone and done okay. I look at Jack. I look at him, and I think we've been blessed. Maybe he can be something more.
He's a good kid. He can be whatever he wants to be. He ain't gonna be no frontier gunslinger killing and running those gang, though. That way's over. Railroads and government, motor cars and everything gone and done away with all that.
And he ain't gonna marry no orphaned working girl running with a bunch of hucksters, neither.
If he meets one like you, I hope he'll marry.
Stop. For an illiterate gunslinger, you sure know how to make a girl blush. God damn crows! John! You have got to go deal with them! They've broken into the silo again and are eating all the corn out from it.
Of course, my angel.
Wait, get out of there.
All right, all right.
Come on. Scat. Shh.
So do you think that's like ale and stew? Kill the birds! Protect the corn! Never cannoli. They're getting what they deserve. We're gonna murder every bird in the world, it seems. And I'm fine with that. I know what we'll do. We'll blow up the corn.
Finally. How about that stew?
That was an easy mission. Ah, another!
This way.
So I don't even need to kill them. Uh-oh, there's wolves on the property. That would seem to me to be a far bigger issue than birds eating corn. It's like, oh yeah, you got wolves too. It's like, oh. Game goes on sale this Friday for PC. Probably, yeah, it's probably a small sale. Black Friday probably would make more sense. Holy crap, these things are everywhere. I can probably wait till the next, like, Steam sale when it's like really discounted. But we'll see. Thing I'm undecided on right now is after I beat this today, I might do some Undead Nightmare on Thursday for Halloween, but
it's an adventure.
I don't think I'm gonna like finish it or anything.
Set out in the West, and it tells this amazing story of how people killed.
If I finish this part in a timely fashion, I might even just go ahead and start it today. But I know next week I'm going right to Red Dead 2.
Really big ones in the valley this time of year. We could use the meat. I know you'd rather read your adventures. Trust me, this can be very enjoyable in its own way. I suppose maybe it's a little less dramatic. So, let's go, come on. You may get to see me get gored by some massive wild beast. Then you can write a story about that.
Very funny, Paul. I've forgotten how funny you was.
Grab your things.
Yeah, come on, put the books down. Reading's for nerds. We're gonna kill things.
Come on, let's go! Come on!
What's up, Israel?
You stay back and I'll show you how to make a kill.
Whatever you say, sir.
You sure you're ready for this?
I guess so.
Now the trick to hunting is calm and patience. You gotta think and move like an animal to catch an animal.
A rifle helps, doesn't it?
Help you stand still, son.
Well, I wouldn't know. This is the first time you've taken me hunting.
There's lots of things I ain't done with.
Yeah, Judge hasn't been very good in this postseason at all. Dodgers just have too many good players, which I'm fine with. I'm rooting for the Dodgers to win it, so
you don't seem too excited about
it's fine
that.
With me.
Are you sure you're all right? I mean, I know all that business must have been hard on you.
It wasn't nothing.
Dodgers at least have players I like,
well,
so
it won't happen again. It's over.
Until the next time,
there won't be a next time. Look, you picked up a scent. Come on.
Don't make no more promises, Paul. I've heard them all.
You know, one time I hunted a bear up in Tall
Tree. Both teams are super teams.
I read this story.
But yeah, it's not really about the team I'm rooting for. It's because they've got players I like. I like Freddie Freeman. I like Mookie Betts. I like Shohei Ohtani. So I'm not really rooting for the Dodgers so much as just I'm rooting for those guys. I like the idea of, you know, great players getting a World Series win and particularly at the expense of the Yankees.
This one's mine. Stay with me, son.
Cut the meat.
You just gotta wait for the right shot, not rush it.
That's a big one.
Tomorrow I'll show you how to do this with people.
Tough one, ain't you? Hope you were watching. It'll be your turn next. Go on, Rufus. Sniff us out a couple more. Come on.
to take a shot, Jack?
Oh.
Remember, it's all about timing. Wait for your moment. Don't snatch
at it. I know. I saw how you did it.
If you say so. All right. When he finds him, you take the lead. Go.
Find another one, Rufus.
That's it. Good boy.
Go on, Rufus.
Slow down. Let's go.
Go find him, Rufus. You can do it, Rufus.
There they are. Jack, come on.
All right, Jack. Kill.
You can do this. Come on.
He went and cavalry charged him.
I see one.
Get after him. Don't rush him.
There you go.
Stay calm. Jack, now it's your turn.
Hey, watch it!
Cut the meat! I don't think he finished.
Nice work, son. You're a quick learner. Now come on. Let's get this meat over to the trading post at Manzanita.
You see me?
You did good, son.
Can't we shoot some more?
Only kill what you need. We'll go out again soon.
Y'all gonna like it.
I told you you'd have fun, didn't I?
Murdering wildlife is always fun. Manzanita.
Come on. All right, here we are. Jack, you wait here. I'll be just a moment. How are you, mister?
Oh, he's in the market. Thank you.
Hope you like it.
Happy trails. I always like it.
All done. Let's head home.
Yeehaw.
Let's go.
How much did you make?
Never you mind. Enough to keep Rufus out of the stewing pot for a couple days.
And what about me? What do I get?
You get to eat, son.
But I did half the work. That isn't fair.
What can I say?
Did you really do half, though?
I'll be rich one day. Then you'll see.
I sure hope so. And you can look after us when we get old.
What do you mean, get old? You are old.
We ain't old. Uncle's old.
Well, he should be in a museum.
Yeah, preserved in whiskey for the next 1,000 years. So, you enjoy your first hunting trip? Hey. Whoa there.
Oh, Pa, that was so much fun. I can't rightly believe it. Just like in the books.
We'll do it again soon. Now get to your chores.
Was hunting not a chore? Have to pass some time, I'm sure. Easy enough. I have to do it more than once. Let's see, they got it at 1 a.m. Yeah, and I saw some clips from it. It's pretty embarrassing.
Tensing up.
I'm not.
You are. Your back's tense and it's making the rifle jump. You're holding it wrong. Here, let me show you.
I don't need you to show me, Paul.
I guess not.
Don't show me and you'll just run off again or something. It's better I teach myself.
I ain't going nowhere.
Whatever you say, Paul.
Don't be like that.
Sorry.
Wolf's been after the herd. Gotta get out there and scare him off. You wanna come with me? Safer with two.
Okay.
Yeah, she said something along the lines of voting for her is fulfilling God's will. And I'm like, yeah, about that, sweetheart. And listening to Tim Walz trying to make football analogies is just comical.
Tell me I'm just a boy.
It's gonna take a while for things to get back to normal.
Normal? Was it ever normal?
I don't know, but it'll get better, son. I promise.
I'm sorry, Paul.
You don't need to be.
I'm glad you're home. I really am. It's just every time you go off. Why were you not coming back?
I swear, if it was down to me, I'd never have gone anywhere.
They can't make you, can they?
It's complicated, but seems they can.
Yeah, I know. I wouldn't understand.
Just some things you start have to be finished.
What was your father like?
I didn't really know him. He died when I was just a boy.
What?
Why do you want to know? Look, he's on to something.
You can't be tired already.
Don't fall behind.
Paul, is Uncle really your uncle?
No. At least I sincerely hope not. He's probably lots of people's father, though.
Well, why do you call him Uncle?
Folks always did.
Yeah, Lopez is not a good comedian.
He was old when I was a kid.
He was old when I was a kid, son. God must have had some purpose to keeping him on this earth.
He's incredibly soft and unfunny.
Let's go. That's it, boy.
Well, consistency's not their strong point. We all know they operate by double standards.
That's his signal.
They're not offended, they're being opportunistic. They're hoping other people will be offended for them. Fact is, they're desperate.
Watch yourself now, son. They might turn on it. Go get him, son. Whoa. That's your luck, bud.
Hey, watch it. Come on. Whoa.
Come on. Good work, son. Go on now, Rufus. Find the rest of them.
Come on. We can't stop now.
That ain't all the pack. There's got to be more around.
And I hate to tell you, it is garbage.
Fun killing something you don't like.
Hold up a moment.
Let's go. Yeah. Go find him, Rufus. What do you smell, boy? Come on.
Go get him, boy. Easy.
You can find him, Rufus. Whoa. I see him. Let's go. Come on. Load up now.
Yay, all the wolves are dead.
They won't be after our cattle for a while.
That was some good shooting, son.
So can I go out hunting?
Hold on there, cowboy. You ain't ready for that yet. One step at a time.
Ah, oh, please, Paul.
We'll go out again soon. Catch something nice for your mother cook.
I reckon I can kill a bear, no problem.
I ain't gonna tell you again, Jack. You don't leave the farm without checking with me first, you hear?
Yes, sir, I hear.
Go.
Yeah, it's hilarious hearing Al Sharpton complain about racism, given his racism.
Ma shouted at a guard one time, and he yelled that you were a murderer.
Maybe, but I live my life believing there's a difference between killing and murdering.
Not for the person who's dead.
No, and I guess I've been both. That's how it goes. We all do what we have to survive. And sometimes it ain't pretty, and in the end, we pay the price for what we did.
Like those rustlers who attacked our cattle?
Exactly! Look, when I was a kid, things were different. Rules were different, but that's over now.
Come on! You know, we could be outlaws, you and me.
Come on.
He's like, we could be outlaws, you and me. It's like, yeah, already done it. Been there, done that.
turned into a decent hunter, son. But try to stay out of trouble.
All right. Frickin' uncle. Old uncle and his lumbago. Let's see if he goes to the mission site. Gotta drive more cattle. I hate driving cattle.
Get up, old man.
I am up.
Get up!
There, I'm up. Well, thank the good Lord you're back. Nothing worse for an old man than sleeping in the warm afternoon sun.
You want a long sleep, Uncle? That can be arranged. It'll cost me less than food.
You always was a hard and nasty man, John Marston.
You always was a useless, conniving thief. And where's them cattle? Did you take them to pasture?
He's coming around to that.
When exactly?
It's easy to pick on the elderly. It's easy, but it ain't dignified.
Come on, old man. Do this together.
Nope. Not my horse. Get off my horse, Uncle. Get off.
What? You wake me up and now you want to rest?
Hey. Get off my horse.
There you go.
I will wrestle you off.
Oh,
for heaven's sake. They're gonna make me ride the crap horse. Boo! I will shoot him off. I hate this activity so much.
Let's keep them moving now.
Come on, you stupid cows.
Let's go.
What the hell? Yeah, I saw Whoopi's take. She's insane. No. No. Ooh, that. Ooh. Messed up my cows.
Yo. You folks okay?
I think we're safe. Thank you. I thought we were done for.
Just helping out. Now you take care.
I'm a hero.
The hero return.
Shut it, old man. Come on. Let's get this herd moving again.
John.
Stupid cows. But it's the view. That's all they're good for, is just being insane little banshees. Round up the straggler. You know, the problem is he disappeared. See, this is the map, and he ain't there. I don't know where the bloody straggler went. He's stuck in the dirt.
Come on, forward. Move, come on. Come on.
Yeah, I don't think that's gonna work. Oh my gosh. Can I just kill all of the stupid cows?
No, stop. Let's go.
I'm gonna name all of them Whoopi. Oh shoot, now this. Gotta get behind him.
Come on. Move on. Move on. Yeah. Whoa there. Let's move here, my four-legged friend.
See, that's how you should talk to the women of the view. Steady now, you dumb cows.
my dog. You want to lose him?
You look after the herd. I'll ride back.
No thanks. You got your pound of flesh from me today.
Sorry, just checking some messages. Alright. Now that stupid herding mission's done. My horse back.
How are you, son?
Gosh dang it, Uncle, get off my horse. It's my horse. Yeah, I'm wondering if Anthony Richardson had some kind of health issue. I mean, I never fully bought into him to begin with. I mean, there was a brief stretch where I was like, okay, he's definitely got talent, but he hasn't been very good on return. But I don't really care. It's Indianapolis. Who cares about the stupid Colts? I just want New England to be good eventually. So I'm more worried about what we're doing.
Look at that, old man. There's some Mustangs and some such out there beyond that ridge. Wondering if it was worth getting you and going around some of them up.
Fair enough. We're nearly out of money. Ranch is in turmoil. We may not make it through the winter. What could we possibly want with some good quality horses? Come on.
That tone of voice ain't so becoming on you. Makes you seem all pent up and angry like some Blackwater would-be business tycoon with a bad case of hemorrhoids.
I'll give you a bad case if someone just shot me in the head if you don't hurry up.
Are you gonna mount up, kid?
Yes, on my horse.
Come on, my horse. Follow me.
Now, breaking in horses is fine. This is more or less easy. Tell you this much, I was looking at Kansas City's schedule. It's gravy. Kansas City honestly should go undefeated in the regular season with their crap schedule. Only team they've got coming up that could pose a threat is Buffalo. And we know how that generally goes. And the other day, Alex Smith was still sucking off, like, oh, Mahomes looks better than ever. And I'm like, no, he doesn't. He looks terrible this year. And I'm not saying he actually is terrible. I mean, he's statistically having a crappy year. He has not been good this year at all. He's being carried by his team. But their defense is so good, I'm just like, I don't see who they're losing to.
Calm down now.
Come on, baby. Calm down. Relax now. You were wild.
I got this one for you. Whoa there.
Will you shut up?
All right. More. Dang, I got far away. It's a straggler. Oh, for heaven's sake. There we go. There we go. Easy, easy, easy.
I think that's enough for now. Let's get him back to the ranch.
What's going on, Boosh?
I learned a few things while I was away.
Anything you wanted to know, you only had to ask.
Yeah!
Uncle, you didn't even do anything. Yeah, Boosh, see? I'm sure everything's gonna be fine.
We need to keep him strong.
John's gonna be totally fine. Of course.
Not a bad day's work.
He's like, and I was there.
Bonnie McFarlane. She's a friend. Mm. Saved my life when I went after Bill and nearly got myself killed again.
Oh, now you two's in the habit of sending each other letters. How very nice.
You weren't nothing like that. What's it say?
I don't know.
I mean, it was for Bonnie.
Well, you know I can't read.
Give it here.
Well, then how do you know what her name is?
You read that thing out loud.
I ain't hiding nothing.
Dear John, I miss your girthy sausage.
Need corn sacks. Stop. Emergency. Stop. Weevils and moths ate entire county supply. Stop. Can you help? Not exactly the most romantic request now, is it?
I guess not. She saved your life, you say?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, then you're gonna have to help her and her family out. We've got a plentiful supply of corn sacks over near the silo. About the one thing Uncle didn't manage to have stolen while we was gone. Okay. Hurry back, John. And John, what's she like?
You know.
She's like you, rich and beautiful and has huge tracts of land.
John, wait. I've changed my mind. I'm coming with you. Well, come on, man. Let's get going. I don't think I can let you go off again without me.
Fair enough. I'm glad of the company. You only had to ask.
Ask? I was waiting for you to ask me.
I thought you'd want to keep an eye on the boy.
Oh, while you were off cavorting with cowgirls in the next county? I don't think so, John Marston. You only just got home. That Jack has seen enough of me for a lifetime. So, is she married? This Bonnie McFarlane?
No.
What does she look like?
I don't know. Pretty normal, I suppose.
Normal? What? Normal like me?
No. Normal has been 2 eyes, mouth, nose, that kind of normal.
Huge breasts. You know, normal.
Well, flattery. Now we're finally getting somewhere.
If you find yourself in a hole, the first thing to do is stop digging.
Another pearl of wisdom from John Marston. I sure do miss those.
I never took you for the jealous type, Abigail.
I ain't jealous so much as curious.
You heard what she wrote. It's just some corn. She saved my life, and she was decent enough to me, so I owe her this much at least.
I always thought this was weird, putting this mission on a timer.
Half-dead on the side of the road and took me to the doctor. Most folks would have left me there.
Half-dead from what?
Bill didn't take so kindly to be visiting on him now.
Bill never did like surprises. How was he?
Same as he was when we left. Angry and dumb. Taking his revenge out on the world. People down there was really scared of him.
Of Bill? You gotta be kidding me. He was only frightening if he was afraid of dumb fools.
Bill weren't so bad, but when Dutch went crazy, Bill took it hard.
For a while, we all thought we'd found something right. Better way to live, but it was just a lie. So you saw before they did.
Maybe. But they was still kind of a family.
A family that left you for dead. You knew the truth, John. And they hated you for it.
It's like, what's Bonnie like? She's like you, but blonde and less used up.
Thank you so much. We lost the entire harvest.
Miss McFarlane, I'd like you to meet my wife, Abigail.
Oh, ain't you quite the gentleman all of a sudden? It's a pleasure to meet you, Mrs. Marston. Likewise. Thank you for saving my husband's life and for teaching the miserable goat some manners, among other things. I didn't teach him anything. I know better than to try to change a man. You should meet my father. Oh, people can change, Miss McFarlane. John and I have to believe that more than anybody.
This is a decent first harvest for you, John. You should be proud. That's good land you got there.
How are you feeling, Mrs. Marston? From what your husband told me, it must have been awful for you. I've been through worse, and I knew he'd be back before too long. He can't cook a meal to save his life.
Abigail, in my darkest hours, when I was most homesick, just the thought one of your rat meat stews kept me pushing forward.
Well, about as amusing as a weeping saddle sore, ain't he, Mr. Farland? If you're gonna start yammering about women's work, John, I'd say you might be in the wrong company.
I'd say so, too.
I never felt so outnumbered.
And here Bonnie's giving him a bit of a longing look. It's also the last time she sees him.
Ma'am?
We're back together, ain't we?
Until they decide you all do something else.
Sometimes I think I was the stupid one for believing I could get out. Maybe Dutch, Bill, and Javier were just being honest with themselves.
You ain't perfect, John, and I sure ain't. But you're better than they are, than they were.
Maybe we can't change, but we gotta try, for Jack's sake. Even if we have to start again 100 times, it's better than going back to what we were. How's Jack doing?
Angry, upset. He's been through a lot.
I hope he's gonna be all right.
It's gonna take time. For a while, his world was safe, normally. Then it got turned upside down again.
You ain't saying much about it.
I've tried to talk to him, but how do you explain any of this? What do you say when he asks about Uncle Bill and Uncle Gus? They were family when he was a little boy.
He hides away in those books of his.
Wouldn't you? It ain't like the real world's done him many favors. He's just been kidnapped. He grew up with the gang. That's no lie for a boy.
We did our best to protect him.
Come on, John. He saw things no boy should see.
Well,
yeah, remember those whores we ran with? He saw them. Probably would have had them by now. Pretty sure Jack's mission I have to wait on. Let's see. It is 8. Let me check on Jack. Five AM to 6. I am good with the morning wood. Simon Diggs tore his ACL. I don't know how much it's going to affect him. He hasn't really done a whole lot with Houston so far. I mean, I don't know if I like their chances against Kansas City to begin with, but I don't think too much of it rests on him. Nico Collins is their best receiver.
John!
What is it, old man?
It's Jack. The kid. Well, I just saw him out in the valley. Seems your tail of hunting got the better of him. He said he was going up the pass, track down that grizzly that's been seen up there.
Kid can't hunt a grizzly? Thing will eat him alive.
I know. I tried to stop him.
But you're worthless as a lawyer at a lynch. Damn you, old man. This is my son. Anything happens to him, you wish it was you that bear attacked.
It kind of is. I mean, part of it is Buffalo's offensive coordinator is pretty capable. Like, Buffalo, I have concerns about, but they look a little more consistent at least.
Go on. Find Jack, boy.
I just still don't get why teams make deals with teams like Kansas City. The team at the top is the last one that I would be wanting to deal with.
What you got, boy?
Aside from the fact that you're just helping them win, it's like, you realize that they're smarter than you, right? Like, New England giving up Josh Uche for a 6th-round pick, it's like, why? How does that help us at all? I think this is the last mission before the last showdown. Well, I guess the penultimate showdown, because there is the epilogue. Is Timmy in the well?
Are you up here, Jack? Can anybody hear me?
He's hunting a bear. He enjoyed hunting elk with his pop, so he thought he'd be a man and hunt a bear like a freaking idiot. Did the bear punch you in the face? Sure did.
What the hell were you thinking going off on your own? You're just a boy.
No, I'm not. I can skin an elk, break horses.
Come on, let's get you home.
But you can't hunt a bear. No, if I meant that he was hunting a big hairy gay man, I would have just said it.
You all right?
Yeah, I think so.
You're lucky to be alive, you stupid boy. What'd I tell you about going off by yourself?
I go off by myself plenty. You just don't know about it. You're never around.
So this is my fault? You disobeyed me.
I was trying to prove myself.
Prove what? By getting yourself killed?
You're always telling me I read too many books, that I'm not a real man.
I never said that.
I just thought if I could do something you'd like, maybe you wouldn't go away again.
Son, I ain't going anywhere. And believe me, neither are you for a real long time.
It's like, do you not see how stupid that logic is? It's like, you know what? I was getting ready to leave for good, but then Jack killed a bear, and I was like, huh, I think I'll stay.
Please don't be angry.
I ain't angry. I'm disappointed. Don't you ever run off on your own like that again.
All right, I told you I was sorry.
What would have happened if I hadn't come along?
I don't know. I'd probably be dead.
You'd be a pile of bones right now.
What would you care? I'm just a nuisance to you anyway.
That ain't true, Jack. I'd do anything for you. You know that.
I guess there's only room for one hero in this family.
Trust me, son. I ain't no hero. I'm just glad you're safe.
Please put that gun away. My head hurts.
Come on. Come on. Going after a grizzly? What were you thinking? You've only been hunting twice.
I'm not a little kid anymore. What were you doing at my age?
Bad things. Things nobody should do. But your ma and me, we didn't have what you have.
Yeah, yeah, I know. I should be grateful.
I'm not asking you to be grateful. I'm asking you to do what I say before you get yourself killed.
It's always one set of rules for you and another set for everybody else. You think I don't know what you did back in the old days? I'm not stupid.
You could have fooled me.
You think I didn't sit up and listen to Dutch and Bill telling all those stories? You think I don't know who you are?
It ain't no secret I didn't get these scars falling over in church.
But nobody tells me anything. You and Ma pretend like nothing happened.
We just want a better life for you, son. Now rest. We'll have you home soon. Come!
I am Jack's complete lack of common sense.
I'm sorry I made you worry, Pa.
Don't be too eager to grow up, son. Ain't as much fun as it looks. When you're ready to hunt bears, I'll take you.
Hey, Jack.
Well, here we go.
Need a hand with that?
No, sir, I got it.
Looks like you have. You know, you're real good with them tools.
Thank you, Paul.
We'll make this land real nice one day. Me and your mother do our part. By the time your turn comes, hell, this could be the nicest farm in the county.
Maybe, Paul.
Sell all kinds of drugs.
Just gotta learn to shoot straight or you'll get yourself eaten by some animal.
Very funny, Paul.
Thank you, son. Soon it'll be quail season. We should have some fun then.
Is there anything you don't like shooting, Paul?
Well, I ain't met the thing yet, but as soon as I do, I'll let you know.
White people.
One of them books you read.
Yeah, maybe I'll do that. Today, John Marston stopped shooting.
Now, I ain't no literary man, but I don't think that'll sell. People like shooting in them things.
I think you may be right there, Paul.
So, you ever hear talk about them machines that can make a man fly?
Well, sure, Paul. Everybody knows about that. You know they're going to be bringing one of those machines around the country next year for a demonstration? One of them machines can turn men into angels.
One of them machines can turn men into angels.
Yo,
Jack, go into the house, lock all the doors. Whatever happens, don't come outside. You hear me? Whatever happens.
Okay.
Come here, son. Whatever happens, keep the doors locked and your mother inside. Promise me, son. Promise me.
Who is it, Pa?
It's just some old friends. Me and Uncle take care of it. And you go inside and you keep the doors and the windows locked.
I hear you.
Then run!
Yeah, run, boy.
Well, old man, looks like things is about to get settled once and for all.
So it seems.
For the love of God!
Here we go.
Come on now!
I picked a bad spot. This is the army. This is the pretty much the same people I was helping before. Basically, Ross and their and his men coming to finish off the rest of the gang.
Come on, man! Come on! Can't stay out here. Get inside. I'll keep watch out here. Get in there. There'll be more coming.
What are we gonna do now?
What's wrong? What's happened?
Stay inside, you hear? Like I said, there'll be more coming.
Hang on just one sec. Alright, sorry about that.
I don't know, son.
I think they want to kill.
No, I ain't gonna let that happen.
Come on now! Stop that!
Rufus, go away.
Don't make me kill
you! Nope, Uncle. Dick shot. It's Helm's Deep.
Take them and Don't worry about me. Let's get him out of here.
No! Uncle, please! Oh my God! They killed him!
Come on, son! Ain't nothing we can do for him now! We're leaving the farm. I'll watch from the silo. You two go to the barn. Get the horses ready.
John!
I'll meet you there.
Good shot.
Don't move until I got you covered.
Oh crap.
None of you bastards are leaving here alive! It's gonna take more than one of you, partner! Alright, you're covered!
Jack, Gnarly, get on this horse. Get out of here. Go find a place to hide.
You're coming with us, Paul.
I'll catch up. Keep riding and don't look back. Don't be worried about me, you hear? Now get going.
You stay out of trouble, John.
Ain't no trouble, Abigail. Ain't no trouble. I love you.
I love you.
Now go! Get!
Oh, That's a rough way to go.
Did you hear that? Jack, we have to go back for Pa.
Let's go!
Western sky on the lone prairie.
Alright, so we have jumped ahead now of apparently 3 years. So now both Abigail and John have passed. So you're Jack Wagon now, yep. I am the Jack.
Hello, ma'am. Oh. My condolences.
Oh, my dear Harold, I can't believe he's gone. I knew his frequenting that gambling boat would be the death of him. The death of him. Oh, Harold Thornton, I missed you.
Oh, poor Harold.
I heard that Doc Trollope Clara laughing at the funeral. I can't understand how strangers can be so true. The world is a sad and terrible place. God preserve his soul.
I'm real sorry for your loss, ma'am. Take care. Hello, sir. You work with the government? You one of them agents?
Sure, son. Why you ask?
Did you work with a man named Edgar Ross? I have something for him.
Edgar Ross? No, but well knew of him. A fine man if he wanted results. Won himself a chest full of medals. I think he went and retired about a year ago. Last I heard, him and his wife moved out to a cabin on Lake Don Julio. Lucky guy. Getting to take it easy. He's fighting crime in this dump, that's for sure.
Well, thank you for the information, mister.
I believe that guy was at the bank counting money last time I saw him. The Prohibitionists. What's this mission?
Hey there.
Do you support temperance?
God damn it! Yeah.
Here's your money.
Here's the money he stole.
You are a saint and a scholar. Here's the
I bet you're looking for that treasure over in Broken Trees. I can tell.
Whoa, guess I shouldn't have hit the dog.
Let's get going.
You ain't getting $5 from me. The dog was to blame.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Hello, young man.
Hi.
What are you doing out here? Are you out visiting the lake with your family?
No, ma'am. I was looking to deliver a letter to Edgar Ross.
That husband of mine. That bureau just won't get its talons out of him, even though he's retired. Edgar gave them some of the best years of his life. They ought to let him retire in peace. They'll not rest till they've killed him with worry, and he's such a sensitive man. I'm sorry, I shouldn't get so angry. I don't suppose any of this is your fault. There's no need to worry about him nowadays.
Well, where is he?
He and his brother Philip went hunting on the south side of the San Luis River. Be careful crossing over. They were saying it was dangerous.
I sure will, ma'am. And don't worry about a thing. I'm sure your husband will be just fine.
Yeah, about that. Wow, this is my axe. This is John's horse. Either way is fine. Oops, didn't mean to do that. All right, let's head over to him. To see your brother.
Hey there, mister. How's the hunt?
Oh, pretty good, son. Got me a few rabbits, coyote, elk. Still looking for some trophies for the parlor.
I've got a letter here for Edgar Ross. You know him? I heard he was down in these parts with his wife.
Once I know him, he's my brother. Gone down river, duck hunt. Must be a pretty important letter to have come all this way.
Yes, sir. Real important. I'll be on my way home as soon as I deliver this message.
You best be off, then. Just don't get on his bad side. He's got a filthy temper. I'd go now if I was you.
Well, let's go see the man. we're going to deliver a letter to Mr. Walls. Clearly a skilled duck hunter.
Excuse me, you Edgar Ross?
Do I know you?
Forgive me for startling you, sir. I have a message for you. My name is Jack Marston. You knew my father.
I see. I remember your father.
I've come for you, Ross.
And you, boy, have sure shit found.
You killed my father.
Your father killed himself with the life he lived.
You killed him. I saw you.
You keep saying that.
You sent him to do your dirty work.
Then you shot him like a dog.
And I'll shoot you like one too, you little piece of trash. Now get out of here before I kill you as well.
I ain't going nowhere, old man.
Yep, definitely his Inigo Montoya moment. Correct. Well, that does it, ladies and gentlemen. That is the end of Red Dead Redemption. Not the happiest ending. It's actually a pretty melancholy ending. Jack pretty much becomes the thing that John hoped he wouldn't become. A vengeful gunslinger. But all the same, it's one of my all-time favorite games. Top 5. Love it. And now very much looking forward to playing Red Dead 2. I might do a little bit of Undead Nightmare over the next couple of days, maybe. If I am so inclined. Obviously, we got Halloween coming up. I don't think I'll finish Undead Nightmare or anything, but I may still play it a little bit. But we'll see. I am, you know, or I might just start Red Dead 2 tomorrow. Who knows? We'll see. I'm so changeable. Maybe I'll save Undead Nightmare for next Halloween. Who knows? We'll see. But anywho, yeah, this was great. Smash the like, do the subscribe, and I will see you all again soon. Appreciate everyone who joined me. You can catch the re-upload over on Gaming with Gord. Take it easy, y'all. Good night, God bless, and Godspeed.